Welcome to the Master's Child Church, where we are obtaining souls through the Word and retaining souls through love. This is Sunday Morning Manna. If you are a first-time visitor to our page, please type first time in the comments. If you are tuning in from another country or other parts of the world, type in to let us know where you're viewing from. Please feel free to share today's broadcast with as many people as you know. Also, feel free to comment if you get encouraged, blessed, or stirred up as you hear the Word of God. And use the emojis at any time to get our online activity to be heard throughout our time. Thank you for joining our cyber sanctuary. Now let's prepare our hearts for worship.
Welcome, 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 and welcome back. Today is National Back to Church Sunday, and we want to welcome you. Yes, we want to let you know that we are happy that you are a part of our virtual experience today on this Back to Church Sunday. So the Master Child Church Worship Center welcomes you on behalf of our pastor, Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr., and our First Lady, Cheryl Robinson, and our entire MCC family. We love you, and again, we welcome you, and we're glad that you're part of this virtual worship experience. Please take a moment to share this post. Please take a moment, just hit the share button. Let your family, let your friends, let everybody know that we're here giving God praise, and they can come be a part of what is taking place right now. So we want you to know that we believe that love never fails. Here at the Master Child Church, we believe it, and we know it, that love never fails. And because of the love of Christ, we are stronger together. We are unified, and we're stronger together because of God's love. So if you would take a moment, we want to see some hearts. We want to see some hearts in the cyber sanctuary. So if you would, please send us some hearts in the cyber sanctuary. Send some likes. Show the unity and the love that we have because of Christ. Show that we are stronger together. So again, welcome back on this Back to Church Sunday. We're going to start out by giving our reading our scripture, and then we're going to pray and go into our time of worship and word. Our scripture reading this morning is going to come from Psalm 133. We're going to read the entire chapter of Psalm 133. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirts of his garments, as the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, even life forevermore. The word of the Lord is blessed. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you. You are good. You are awesome. We thank you for this day. You've kept us, and we are grateful for your keeping power. We're grateful for your mercy. We would ask you, God, to please forgive us for all the things that we've done and said that wasn't pleasing in your sight. It's our desire that you would get the glory out of our lives and be pleased, Father God. So we thank you for your mercy. We are grateful for your grace. We're grateful for this time that we have to experience this virtual worship experience. God, we know that you are everywhere right now, God. You are omnipresent. We're grateful for your presence. So we thank you that you're receiving our worship now. As we let you, as we continue to lift our hands, as we continue to lift our songs to you from our various destinations, God, we want you to know that we appreciate you and we thank you for all that you've done. God, you know everyone that's tuned in today. You know there's someone with a hung down head. We pray that their head would be lifted. There's someone, Father God, who's weak, but I pray, God, even now, God, that you'll strengthen them. God, we thank you for salvation. We pray that someone's testimony today would be of salvation. We pray that someone would be healed, delivered, and set free. We're grateful for the word that's going to come forth on this Back to Church Sunday. We pray, God, that our hearts will be open to receive all that you have for us, Lord God, on this Sunday morning. God, we thank you. Lord God, you are awesome. You are worthy. We thank you for your sovereignty. We thank you for you being able to do all things, Father God. There's nothing that you aren't able to do. So whatever we need now, we thank you that you're able to do it. We have confidence in you, God. We submit to your will, and we thank you, Lord God, for all that's going to take place today in this worship experience. We give you honor, and we give you praise. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Be blessed. Let's continue to enjoy.
Hallelujah. Come on, Master Child. Let's give God the glory for the wonderful things that he's done. God is great. He's faithful. He's worthy to be praised. And everything that you need is in him. So why don't you just lift your voice and tell him thank you. God, thank you for giving us everything that pertains to life and to godliness. God, we have everything. Everything that we need. For the great I am. Oh, he provides for me. The great I am provides. Come on, let's lift your voice. Say, you are my strength. When I am weak, you are my strength, oh God. When I am weak.
Join Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr. for our new series, It's a Different World, Change is Not an Option. Join us for this new exciting series. Celebrate Recovery. In the midst of uncertainty, Celebrate Recovery is still a strictly confidential and safe place for every hurt, habit, or hang-up. It's a Christ-centered support group designed to help you through the process. Join us Friday, October 2nd at 7 p.m. via our Zoom video conference, strictly monitored. Login information is displayed below. Be sure to join us. The Master's Child Church presents 49-21 Anniversary Celebration, featuring Bishop Jacqueline E. McCullough. Be sure to join us for this exciting celebration coming soon. It's Back to Church Sunday. We want to welcome you in honor of Back to Church Sunday, Stronger Together. Let's take a short virtual walk down memory lane. MCC, We are stronger together.
Welcome to church. The church has always been defined as the people who comprise it. And never just a building for gatherings. The church has never been confined to four walls, because the heart of the church is to reach out to the community and serve. The church is people like you and me, connecting with each other through our faith and being there for each other when we need it most, like right now. In the first years of Christianity, nursing developed as an outreach of the church. This included risking their own health to care for the sick, feeding the hungry, caring for widows and orphans, and clothing the poor. In 369 AD, the church built the first hospital as a place to care for those who could not care for themselves. Fast forward to COVID-19. The virus hit us all hard. The isolation was a new and difficult reality for us. We missed spending time in person with our friends and family. We worried about the pandemic spreading. We were forced to deal with the financial effects of shutting down. In the midst of the hopelessness and fear, the church stepped up once again. We delivered millions of pounds of food to families in need. Lee reached out to people online to spread the gospel's steadfast message of hope. We stayed connected to each other and our neighbors through whatever means we had to. We realized we need each other more than ever before, and we realized we'll get through this together. We learned that we are stronger together. Now, as things reopen and we can see each other in person, we have a renewed appreciation for moments spent with our loved ones and those in our community. And we, as the church, will continue to reach out to those in need. The world still faces as much trouble as ever, but no matter what happens, we're in this together, and we are stronger together.
We want to thank you for joining us. Now let's get ready to receive today's message with Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr., your senior pastor of the Master's Child Church.
You know, I was thinking as we were worshiping together in the cyber sanctuary for the glory of God, that life is really about perspective. You know, when you are reminded that you have everything, you have everything. And the reason why you have everything is because everything we need is in Him. That's a wonderful thing to know. That is nothing that I am void of. That there's nothing that I cannot have. That there is nothing that will escape of my life. Simply because I have the right perspective. It's what God has for me, it's for me. And that brings us to the understanding as to why it is so important to understand that we are in such a good place because we serve a God that has everything. In fact, He is our everything. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. For that awesome worship experience. I really, really enjoyed it as much as I saw. It was just fantastic. And we give it up to our minister of music and to our MD and to all those who participated in bringing us to this place of worship, our dancers and singers and musicians, I mean, everyone. Everyone who works behind the scene, thank you so much for what you are doing, because you are really, really taking us to where we need to be when it comes to this place that we must occupy, this place of worship. And all of our worship, it belongs to God. All of our praise, it belongs to God. Everything we have, it belongs to God, because what He has, it belongs to us. So we have everything. Need healing? He has it. Need financing? He has it. Need peace? He has it. Everything. Everything. Anything that you can think of. Everything. We have at our disposal. And it's because of our relationship with God. I'm excited about that. I am. I'm very excited about that. Well, good morning, everyone. And praise the Lord to everyone who's in attendance. We greet you in that wonderful name, Jesus, the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ, He is Lord. Anybody believe that in the cyber? Anybody believe that? I believe you do. Yeah, we believe it in Jesus' name. We honor everybody who's with us on this morning. This is National Back to Church Sunday, and welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. Yeah, you're more than welcome. And I speak on behalf of myself, First Lady, and the entire NCC Nation. Welcome back. Welcome back. If you're here with us for the first time, we would love to know that. Type that in the comments section, would you? Just say, I'm just first time. Some of you visiting with us every weekend. We honor you as well. And then Master Child, you know what's up. You already know what's up. Your pastor loves you most much. And thank you so much for hanging in there. Thank you for your commitment. Thank you for remaining connected. Thank you for your contributions. Thank you for everything you mean to all things MCC. We really appreciate you in Jesus' name. I want you to prepare your hearts to give. And I pray that we have come to a point where we realize that we can't be God-given no matter how we try. The more we give, the more he gives unto us. God is doing some wonderful things at The Master's Child Church. And I want to thank God. I do. I want to back up just a little bit. Just thank God for the Master's Child family. On behalf of myself, First Lady, I speak on behalf of the leadership and all the associate pastors, everyone. We thank God for the Master's Child Church family. You guys are the best. You know, I'm on the mic, so I'm quite sure every pastor thinks that their membership is the best, but I want to say it out loud. MCC is the best church family on this side of heaven. And I thank God for every last one of you, every last one of you, every last one of you, every last one of you. I thank God for you. And so as we give, I want you to know that I'm praying that what you give would be much smaller than what you receive in return. God is doing some wonderful things. I want you to know that when it comes to what we're doing at our 23-acre campus in Indian Head, Maryland, it's in full effect. Things are going, very, very well. And we thank the Lord for that. I want you to know that we've been able to renovate bathrooms and we've done some renovations in the sanctuary as well. So I tell you, it's just a wonderful thing to see what God is doing, even in the midst of what we've been going through, reference this pandemic. And so all those who are joining us this morning, we do have a video of our plans as it relates to the building of our 1,500 seat cathedral that's in full effect. You should see it at some point. Maybe you're seeing it now. But I want you to know that God is doing some wonderful things, some absolute wonderful things. On the behalf of Master Child, and we wouldn't be able to do it without your giving. And so it's offering time in the Cyber Sanctuary. I want everyone listening to me, sow your tithe, sow your offerings, sow your seeds, because you can't be God-given no matter how you try. The more you give, he'll give back unto you in Jesus' name. All right, so we have various ways that you can give. You can give via Cash App, masterschild.org. You can call 301-200-1615. You can do that. Give it a five. We have various ways that you can give. And so we pray that you would find it in your heart to be a blessing to this ministry. All right. Thank you so much. Thank you so much in advance. For what it is that you do contribution-wise for MCC. All right? So as you're giving, I want to pray that God will bless your seeds. And I want you to sow according to your faith and believe in God for what it is that you need. And I believe God will return to you that which you have sown, but sometimes he'll give you and return to you and bless you with things that money cannot buy. And those are the things that I'm grateful for, you know, things I can't pay for, things I can't write a check for. You know, these are the things that God miraculously do in my life, and I'm thankful for him being that kind of God. So let's pray. Father, I thank you because we don't spend the seed. We don't save the seed. We sow the seed, and we do it for your glory. And as we are giving, God, we're giving by faith. And God, I ask that you bless everyone who's making a contribution to this ministry for your glory. And God, we dare not rob you. You've just been too good. You've been too good to us to rob you. No way. We just can't do that. And we're going to release that which belongs to you. We receive what belongs to us. So now it's time for us to release unto you what belongs to you. And so we do it in faith. And we do it cheerfully. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your giving. I really appreciate it. And if anybody is joining us even now, your first time visitor with us on this National Back to Church Sunday, please note that. In fact, send some emoji. Listen, I need my emoji ministry to send some love up right now for all of our visitors. Can we do it one more time for all of our visitors? Please show some love for those individuals. Some may be just tuning in and they didn't get no love in the beginning. Let's give them some love right now because we are a church that believes that love never fails. All right. Well, I want to thank God for Pastor Andre, Pastor Sam, and Pastor Matthews. I wasn't with you all in terms of speaking on last Sunday. I wasn't with you on Wednesday. And I want to thank these great associate pastors for standing in my stead. They have always done a wonderful job. Always. They have always done a wonderful job. I want you to send some love up for them. You know, I'm telling you, it's a lot that I know I would not be able to accomplish if it wasn't for our wonderful, absolutely excellent, and awesome associate pastors. They are with you Monday through Friday, every morning at 6 a.m., praying, starting your morning off with prayer. You're able to contact them and speak with them and get encouragement and guidance from them. They do all types of things outside of their pastoral duties. And so I want to love on them. I really want to love on them. And even our elders and, you know, Elder Tracy and Elder Carlton and our ministers, all our ministers, thank you so much. And deacons, thank you so much for what you do behind the scenes. These are things that people don't even see happening, but you are as committed to those things, even when nobody is looking at you. So I do want to take this opportunity to thank every last one of you because you mean so much to this ministry. Really, really appreciate you and what you do behind the scenes. And I pray that God would reward you richly for the way that you have embraced the assignments that's on your lives and how you have performed those assignments in the spirit of excellence. We love you and we thank God for every last one of you. The book of Ezekiel, I need your attention for a few minutes because I want to talk regarding a topic that I think it's going to fit in the context of our occasion today. You know, this is National Back to Church Sunday. But then I think it's going to fit into the context of your life, uniquely and individually. It's a lot of stuff. I think it's a lot of things going on in our lives uniquely that we need a word for. We need a word for. We need a word for these things. And if you would just give me your attention for just a few minutes, I think the word that you need today is coming your way. The word that you need today is coming. It's coming your way. Ezekiel 37, I want you to meet me at the 7th verse. I'm reading out of the Contemporary English Version. If you have another version, it's okay. We're in the same neighborhood. All right. So I want you to consider Ezekiel 37. I'm going to read verses 7 through 10. My key verse will be 10. And this is what the word of the Lord says. It says, I did what the Lord said, but before I finished speaking, I heard a rattling noise. The bones were coming together. I saw muscles and skin cover the bones, but they had no life in them. But 8 says, and the Lord said, Ezekiel, now say to the wind, the Lord God commands you to blow from every direction and to breathe life into these dead bodies so they can live again. So as soon as I said this, the wind blew among the bodies and they came back to life. They all stood up and there were enough to make a large army. Let the sanctuary say, amen. Look at verse 10. I just want that A clause. When it says, as soon as I said this, the wind blew among the bodies and they came back to life. It came back to life. I want to use for a topic this morning entitled, From Valley to Vitality. From Valley to Vitality. Let's pray. Father, I thank you so much for this awesome opportunity that you've given me to minister to your people. You knew who would be in the cyber sanctuary. It's their word. Yeah, you gave me a word for these individuals specifically, and I want to speak, I want to teach with clarity. Yes, I want to represent you properly in the spirit of integrity in terms of what you're telling me to say. I don't want to say anything outside of what you are guiding me to say. So God, help me to be obedient to your flow, your revelation. Whatever it is that you want to say, God, I'm here, use me. For your glory, in Jesus' name, amen. Well, I want you to, when you get an opportunity, I want you to consider Ecclesiastes 4 and 12. That's really the text that is officially connected to the theme for National Back to Church, a Sunday, which is Stronger Together, Stronger Together. And if you read the NIV, it will say that one, though one will be overpowered, two can defend themselves, but a cord of three strands is not quickly broken. And when you read that text, what it's saying is that there's strength in numbers. You know, you have the one that would be overpowered. You have the two that could defend themselves. You have the cord that has three strands. It is not quickly broken. Strength in numbers. It's that cord with the three strands I really want to focus in on, because out of all the numbers, that's the greater of the three. It's those three strands. Each rope contributes to the cord. Each rope contributes to the cord, and it's their togetherness. It's the togetherness of those three cords that we find strength. You see, it's putting those three strands together that forms the cord. That's where the strength lies. Because anything you put together strength will be the end result. And this is why we all must endeavor to operate in the spirit of togetherness, for we are stronger together. We are. And togetherness produces strength that serves as preventative, as a preventative measure to avoid brokenness. And I want to say this because there are many things the enemy sends your way that can break you down. Many things he sends your way that can break you down, but nothing, in my opinion, can break you down like being in a prolonged valley experience. Because, see, a prolonged valley experience dries up what's essential to your life until it breaks you down. And you alone are too weak to get it together. Have you ever had one of those moments that you went through something so long that you just couldn't get it together? Just couldn't get it together. And in that instance, it really speaks to how you've been in a prolonged valley experience. And I want you to understand that my declaration to you is this: don't let a valley break you down. Don't let a valley break you down. I pray, hear me good, that you never break down in a valley. Never. That you will never break down in the valley, because this is why the psalmist said, "Yea, though I walk through the valley, not break down in the valley." No, the goal is to walk through the valley, not break down in the valley. And this is what we see amongst the children of Israel. The children of Israel, they have been broken down. They have been broken down in a valley. And God sends Ezekiel as a prophetic voice to speak to them in the midst of their brokenness. Ezekiel, the prophet, says, in the context of our text, he says, the Lord's power has taken control over me. And not only that, his spirit has carried me to a valley full of bones. And this is a metaphoric image of the state that Israel is in. Israel has come to a point where they've been in a prolonged valley experience to an extent that they felt like their promise dried up because they had been removed from their homeland. They felt like God's presence had dried up because they could not feel his presence amongst them, and they had no hope that there would be a regathering, physical regathering to their homeland, or even a spiritual regathering back to God. They were in a prolonged valley experience. Ezekiel is carried under the control of God in this vision to a valley full of bones. One of the reasons why I believe that God carried Ezekiel to this valley full of bones from a metaphoric perspective is because you cannot be effective amongst people that you cannot relate to. And relatability is really based on understanding, not just understanding the experiences of the people that you're talking to, but experiencing those issues yourself. And so God allowed Ezekiel, vision-wise, in the spirit, to experience what was going on in the lives of the Israelites. And he's there and he says, I look all around me. I looked all around me and all I saw was a valley full of bones that were dried out. That's all I saw, just a valley full of bones that were dried out. They were just dried out. And I want you to understand the reason why the valley was full of bones is because the bones were not together. The bones were disconnected. They were not together. Bones were everywhere. There was no togetherness. There was no connection. The bones were everywhere. I mean, what the Israelites went through, it reduced them to disconnection, separation. It reduced them down to bones that were dried out. Ezekiel said something that was very, very important in this text as he's given us the conversation that he's having with God in this text. He said, God told, asked him, he said, Ezekiel, look around you. Can these bones live again? Can these bones come back to life? I know what you see. I know what you see, but can they come back to life? Ezekiel replied to God. He said, listen, God, you're the only one that can answer this. I have no answer for what I'm seeing right now. This is where I need to be with somebody this morning. Have you ever looked around your space, looked around your life? You ever looked around this world? You ever looked around your surroundings? You ever check your surroundings out and everything you see looks like it's just drying up? And people will have to act, sometimes will ask you, do you think you can bounce back? Do you think you can get back to a better place? Do you think that you can rebound? Do you think that you can be restored? And sometimes you don't have an answer for what it is that you see going on around you. And I thank God for Ezekiel. I really do. Because now I don't feel bad because I have to understand. Yes, I'm a pastor. I love the Lord. Yes, I'm saved. But I'm telling you, there's some things that goes on around me. And when I look at it, I just don't have an answer for it. I don't. And people will want you to explain, like, what happened? I don't know. How are you going to make it? I don't know. How are you going to bounce back? I just don't have no answer for it. And Ezekiel said, God, you asked me a question, but for real, the only one who has an answer to the question that you asked me is you. Is you. And this is where God wants us this morning. Hear me. He says, I know you are looking for answers that you cannot provide yourself. But the one thing he wants you to know that there's no answer that you're looking for that he cannot provide. Somebody's going to get an answer this morning. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, but somebody's going to get an answer. That question that you've been having for the last 5 years, that question that you've been just pondering on, that question that's been wearing your mind out, what you've been seeing and what's been going on in your surroundings, you look at it and say, I just don't have no answer for this pain, this misery. I don't have no answer for what is happening in my life. Every now and then you have to be like Ezekiel and say, God, I don't know, only you know. And God says your answer is coming this morning. Somebody's going to get an answer. See, sometimes we thank God and we praise God for material things and all that is fine. But this morning, we're going to praise him for answers because the devil should have never let us come into this cyber sanctuary. Because if I get an answer for what's been challenging me for the last 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, even now, as to why some of this stuff happened, I don't have no answer for it. It just happened all of a sudden. I looked around and things became different than what they were. I'm looking around my life and looking at my family. I'm looking at my finance. I'm looking at my health. How in the world did I end up in this place so disconnected, so detached from that which I am used to, and then I'm getting questions, can you live? Can you bounce back? Can you be restored? And I want you to know, you don't have to feel bad about that, because the prophet just freed us, because he told God, God, I don't know that, but you know the answer to this. And he said, okay, fine. I got you exactly where I want you to be, because you're going to be a prophet and not have all the answers. You can be a bishop and not have all the answers. You can be a child of God and not have all the answers. You can be a pope, not have all the answers. You can have a college degree and not have all the answers. You can be rich and not have all the answers. There's some answers that only we can get from God. And God says, you're right. He says, so this is what I want you to do. I want you to say to those dry bones, right where they are, speak to those dry bones, right where they are. Sometimes we only speak to situations, we only speak to people when they get to where we feel they should be, that would warrant a conversation with them. Sometimes you have to speak to people where they are. He says, speak to the bones right where they are, detached, disconnected. I mean, bones all over the valley. As a matter of fact, they're in the valley. But you got to speak to them where they are. And I don't know where you are right now, but I came to speak to you because God told Ezekiel to tell the dry bones to listen to what the Lord is saying to you. Lord, help me here. If you would just listen, I know you're in a bad spot, but just listen. I know everything looks like it's just broken down, but listen. I know problems are everywhere, but just listen. I know that things look like it's just crazy right now, but can you just listen? Just listen, just for a few more minutes. He told Ezekiel to tell the dry bones to listen what the Lord is saying. He said, I, the Lord, he's speaking on God's behalf. He says, I, the Lord God, will put breath in you. And once again, you will live. He said, I'm going to wrap you with muscles and skin and breathe life into you. And then he said, then you will know. Then you will know. But I don't think you really know. He said, but then you will know that I am the Lord. God will bring you back to a place that you thought you would never, ever get to again. And when God does it, if you had any doubt as to whether or not he is Lord, when God does something like that for you, God's intent is for you to understand that can't nobody do you like him. I got about four people who's listening to me right now and you know that nobody can make you doubt him. You know he's Lord. Based on that pain he brought you through, you know he's Lord. Based on that misery he brought you through, you know he's Lord. The way he's restored your life, you know he's Lord. In other words, it's nothing that you can make me believe other than the fact that he is Lord, because I see what he has done for me. What he has done for me keeps confirming over and over and over that he is Lord. Lord over my valley, and Lord over my brokenness, and Lord over my pain, and Lord over my frailties. He is Lord. Every now and again, you just got to praise him and thank him because of the things that you know now. There's some things I didn't know. But after he brought me out of some of the stuff that I thought I would never, ever get out of, I now know that he is Lord. Do I have about 40 people who can go in agreement with me based on the things that God has done for you and say, God, you are Lord. You are Lord. I praise you because you are Lord and you can do absolutely anything but fail. I hope somebody is listening because this is your word. based on where we are right now, your brokenness is not permanent. I wish I had somebody here. I know you're going through some, but your brokenness is not permanent. If you just listen, you coming out of that valley. No, you don't get your vitality back. You coming out of that valley. Things are getting ready to come together. You have to understand in your spirit, whatever you're going through in the area of brokenness, the only reason that you're experiencing that brokenness is because you've been in a prolonged valley experience, but things are getting ready to come together. Why? Because God has spoken some things that you've been listening to. For the Bible says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And Ezekiel now has a word to speak to these bones, which is a metaphoric image of the state that the Israelites are in. And he sees them in their bone state. See, some people won't speak to you until you get your muscles, until you get your skin back, until you recover. But I need somebody to speak to me when life reduced me down to bones. I don't have nobody. That's what I need a word for. When life reduced me down to bones, I need a word. And God put a word in Ezekiel's spirit. And the Bible says, now we are in the text. He said, I did what the Lord said. I wish I had somebody here. I did what the Lord said. But before I finished speaking, I heard a rattling noise. Listen, this is for about 10 people real quickly who's been listening. I'm talking about people who's been listening, because everything starts with what you hear. You have to be listening up to this point. This word is for everyone who's been listening. God said, if you just do what I tell you to do before you finish, something is going to turn. Something is going to manifest. He said, I did what the Lord said, but before I finished speaking, I heard a rattling noise and the bones were coming together. I'm going to say that again. He said, I did what the Lord said, but before I finished doing what he asked me to do, I heard a rattling noise. The bones were coming together. I elaborate to educate. These are for the listeners again. He said, I did what the Lord said, but before I got finished, before I completed what he asked me to do, I heard a rattling noise, for the bones were coming together. Now, let me deal with this. Let me deal with this, because somebody ought to know that you just got your answer. Just do what the Lord said. And God said, before you finish, I'm going to turn it around. Before you finish, things are going to come together. Before you finish, something is getting ready to shift in your life. All you have to do is continue to do what the Lord says. He'll bless you before you complete it. He'll bless you right while you're doing what he's telling you to do. He's going to bless you before you get done. I wish I had somebody here. The thing that really intrigued me was this rattling noise. He says, I was doing what the Lord says, but before I finished speaking, before the message was over, before Bishop was finished preaching, before the service was over, I heard this noise, this rattling noise, because the bones were coming together. As I'm speaking, something should be coming together. Something should be coming together. And I want you to understand this rattling noise is a sound. Noise is just a sound. Noise is just a sound. But can I break it down even further? Sound is a sign. Sound is a sign that things are coming together. If it was quiet right now, I would be concerned. I want to ask you a question. Have you ever wondered why you felt rattled in the midst of some of the things you experienced in life? I want you to know that God uses the rattling to indicate to you that reconnection is in progress. I wish I had six people in that pod. In other words, he's reconnecting everything that light shattered. He's connecting everything that was broken. I want somebody to hear this word. Reconnection is in progress. Reconnection is in progress. He's reconnecting everything that was broken, everything that was shattered. That's good for your life going forward, simply because you have determined in your mind that I'm going to do what he says. I'm going to do what he says. Not only that, but I'm listening. He may not have had my attention before this valley experience, but based on everything I've been going through, this prolonged valley experience, I want you to know that he has my attention and I'm doing what he says. And God says, when you do what I tell you to do in the midst of doing it, I want you to know that whatever sounds you hear, even when you feel rattle is indicating to you that reconnection, that rattling is an indication to you that reconnection is in progress. Now, let me tell you a little bit about reconnection. Reconnection always starts with doing what the Lord says. When God is getting ready to reconnect you to the promise and reconnect you to your purpose and reconnect you to your assignment and reconnect you to the things that's going to take you to another level, reconnection always starts with what the Lord says. And what really got me is when, and I need you to hear me, listen to this right here. When Ezekiel says, I saw bones coming together, but I saw muscles and I saw skin that covered the bones. I saw skin, I saw muscles that covered the bone. I'm gonna say it again. I saw skin, I saw muscles and skin cover the bones. I want to stop right here. I want to stop right here because this is where you really need to give me your attention. You have to give me your attention. Please listen to me. When you see this taking place, this observation of Ezekiel, he says, the bones are coming together. He said, but I saw the muscles and skin cover the bones. What you have to understand, that we have a tendency of covering up that which makes us look flawed. I don't have nobody. I don't have nobody. Yeah, because the muscles and the skin that covers the bone, that's about image. I gotta protect my image. I gotta put some skin on it. I gotta put some skin on the bone. I gotta put some muscle on the bone so I can at least look strong. At least I can look strong. I can look vitalized. I can look like I have vitality. I can look like I'm successful. I can look like I'm prosperous. All I have to do is cover up what makes me look flawed, because I gotta protect my image. I gotta make sure that nobody knows about this bone. I don't mind bringing the skeleton out the closet as long as I can put some skin on it, and as long as I can put some muscle on it, as long as I can put a career on it, as long as I can put some makeup on it, as long as I can put a suit on it, as long as I can put some money on it, as long as I can cover it up, because I don't want nobody to know about my bones. I don't have nobody. I don't, because I have an image to protect. I have to have a certain image. I have to have this image that everything is fine. I have no problems. I'm good. I'm okay. I'm all right. I got to put some skin. I got to put some muscle. I got to put some. I don't want nobody to know about my bones. I don't want nobody to know about my bones because I have an image. The problem is you have image, but you are impotent. Yeah, you have image, but you're impotent. You're still lacking life. Because the Bible says they had the skin on the bone. They had muscles on their bone. Looked like they were strong. Looked like they were revitalized. Looked like they had it going on. But the text went on and said, but they had no life in them. Life does not work like that. All of us have bones. I wish I had a real, you see, you can't get to vitality if you're not honest about your value. You can't see the reason why people can't relate to you is because you know they understand what it feels like to be reduced down to a bone and feel embarrassed about it, to be reduced down to a bone and not feel good about it. The flaws and the mistakes and the frailties and all the embarrassments. See, the problem is if you don't have no bones, you can't. If you're pretending like you don't have no bones, then you can't relate to me. And really, you're not lying. You're not fooling me because everybody has bones. I don't have nobody here, but someone just know how to cover those bones up. Real good to the extent that your image just looks so good, but you got image, but you're impotent. You're impotent and you're lacking a lot of light because light does not work like that. And I'm asking you to get to a place where you understand that, yes, I got some bones. I know what it is to be reduced to bones, but God took what was left of me. Hallelujah. And he put these things back together again because you have to understand that all things, your frailties, your faults, your mistake, your embarrassment, all of it work together for your good according to, I want you to understand that the purpose of God, it works according to the purpose of God. All things work together for the good of them who are the call of God. I want you to understand that it's a purpose for what you went through. It's a purpose for the things that you've experienced. It's a purpose for the things that God brought you out of. And you cannot act like that your bones wasn't a part of the process. All things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and to those who are called according to his purpose. And I want five people to be honest with me. Be honest with me. Be honest with those who are in a cyber sanctuary that you know what it is to experience a prolonged valley to the extent that life has been at some point reduced you down to bones. You tried to cover it up, but it's still there. You tried your best to hold your image together, but at the same time you were impotent. That's because you have to understand that life doesn't work like that. You don't have life. You have an image, but you don't have life. You're breathing, but you don't have life. For Ezekiel said, yes, the skin came and the muscles came, but they had no life in them. And I'm asking you to get your life back. I know you got image, but do you have life? I know you have a career, but do you have life? Jesus said that I came that you may have life and have life more abundantly. Your bones have purpose because it always reminds you of what God brought you out of. And when people begin to look at your life, don't look at my image. Don't look at my car. Don't look at my career. Let me tell you about my bones. I almost dried up. I almost lost it. I almost didn't come back from the valley that I experienced. I know what it is to cry all night, not have answers. I know what it is to be in a place and feel like God has forgotten me, feel like the promises have dried up. I feel like his presence has dried up. But all of a sudden, he sends a word, and I've listened to this word. I've had an opportunity to listen to this word. He has my attention, calls me to do what it is that he has asked me to do. And here I am, bones and all, standing. I'm surviving. I'm making it. You know why? Because he gave me my life back. I want my life back. I, I want my life back. I want that life that Jesus has for me. And Ezekiel said, if they don't have no life, that's fine. They got the skin and muscle. But I want you to know that your assignment is not finished. He tells Ezekiel to speak to the wind. Hallelujah. Speak to the wind. Speak to what you cannot see. Wind, you can hear, but you can't see it. He says, speak to the wind and tell the wind the Lord God commanded to blow from every direction. Breathe into these dead bodies until they live again. I'm telling you, I'm asking God, I by the power of God, I pray that the wind of this word, hallelujah, that the wind of this word blows on every person that's listening to me right now, because you need a breather. You got to catch your breath. Sometimes you can be in the valley so long and looks like nothing is coming in your direction to help you to regain your life and to be restored and be renewed and to come together again. And I want you to understand, when those bones begin to come together again, that's when you start seeing things happen, muscles and skin and life and wind. It's because of the togetherness. The vitality is really based on understanding. Understanding at this point that when God is ready to take you from the valley to vitality, you must understand this is a life or death situation. You have to learn how to speak to what you can't see, and whatever has not been coming into your direction for years and for years and for years, you have to learn how to speak to it by using the name of God and commanding it to come into your direction. I need the wind of the word to come in my direction. I need the wind of victory to come into my direction. I need the wind of peace to come into my direction. I need the wind of power to come into my direction. I want you to know that something is coming in your direction as I speak, because I want you to understand you have to catch your breath. You need a breather. You need a breather. You need something. You need the wind of God's word to breathe on you, because I want you to feel again. I want you to feel again what it is to be alive. I want you to know what it feels like again to be alive, to be vibrant, to have vitality. Because sometimes you can be in the valley so long that you can get content with being in the valley, that you feel like there's nothing. No, God has some vitality awaiting for you. He has some vitality awaiting you. And I want you to see this in this text. He says, I want you to blow on them until they come alive again. And I pray that this word has been blowing on you. I pray that the wind of this word has been giving you life and vitality, because your valley season is over. I said your valley season is over. It's about vitality, because things are coming together again. When those bones start coming together, everything start coming into their direction. And God is saying, listen, it's time for you to hook back up. Hook back up to the body. Hook back up to the body. Get reconnected to the body. Because God said, I'm sending things in the direction of those who are hooked up and connected to the body. Bring all bones, mistake, bring everything that's associated with your life, because the wind is blowing. The wind is blowing. Stay in the wind. Stay in the wind. The wind of the word is blowing for a purpose, because it's breathing life back into you, because you will absolutely live again. I can't live without the wind. I can't live without the wind. I can't live without the word. I can't live without being connected to the body. The body. That was the metaphor. Israel had been reduced to bones and they were separated. They were not together, but the Bible said that the bones came together again. And they began to experience vitality through the spirit of togetherness. 10, and I'll close. And the Bible says, as soon as I said this, the wind blew among the bodies and they came back to life. They came back to life and they all stood up. And there were enough of them to make an army. You've been AWOL. You've been absent without leave. God says this wind was for you. This wind is going to give you enough. As soon as you begin to do what God is telling you to do, this wind is going to give you enough to get back on your feet, to get back in place, to get reconnected with the body of Christ, because this whole occasion is really about you getting reconnected back to the body of Christ, because our goal is for you to get back on your feet. Because this is an army that cannot win, cannot go forward, cannot advance without you. This army needs you. This message that was preached this morning was to make sure that you understand that your valley experience doesn't have to be permanent. The moment we begin to operate, the moment these bones, everybody got to understand, you got bones. The moment these bones begin to connect and come back together, vitality begins to take place. See, we are void of vitality. The valley begins to wins because of the valley. The valley, seems to be victorious. Seems like it's winning because we're disconnected. We're disconnected. And as long as there are some bones missing, see, we'll never have the complete army that God is looking for in his kingdom. Are you a missing bone? We need you. We need you. We got a big fight ahead of us. We need you to be a part of the army of God. We need you. So the wind is giving you an opportunity to be revitalized so you can be a part and be reconnected to what we call the body of Christ. And so God is giving you a word this morning that he wants you back. That's why he didn't let the valley have you. That's why he's bringing you back to vitality. That's why he's giving you life through this word. That's why the wind of the word is blowing in your direction so your strength can be renewed and restored so you can get back on the battlefield for the Lord. See, one will be overpowered. Two, you may be able to defend yourself, but when there is a cord that consists of three strands, you are not easily or quickly broken. And so what I'm telling you today, when we operate in the spirit of togetherness, when we all come together, when we all come together, no valley can keep us, because our vitality is rooted in our togetherness. That's why the Bible says, when it comes to what it is that we need to do in offering up praises unto God, oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. When we exalt his name together, there's a strength that we have when it comes to what we do together that the enemy cannot weaken. You see? So I'm asking you, if you're hearing me, if you're listening to me, because it was Ezekiel said it, I did what the Lord says, but before I finished, I heard a rattling noise and the bones start coming together. I promise you, if you hear and do what the wind of the word is instructing you to do while you're doing it, reconnection will begin to take place. Things will begin to come together in your lives. You don't want image and be impotent. No, no, let's start covering this up. We got some bones we got to deal with, but we still need you. No, bring that bone. We need you. We can work with that. Bring it all to God. God can still strengthen that bone. He still can strengthen you. I don't care what your frailties are, your faults are, your embarrassments are, your weaknesses are. He can strengthen that. Question is, are you willing to do what he said? Are you listening to him? Does he have your undivided attention? Because we need you to be connected properly with the army of God. If you've been listening to me, there's somebody who has to rededicate their lives. There's some few people who are listening to me this morning. You got to rededicate. What a perfect day to do that. Because we're just not trying to get you back to, you know, a life, you know, that would benefit you from a natural perspective, but we're trying to get you back to God. Get you back on the battlefield. Get you back in place. That valley was just a place to make you recognize that when you're disconnected and you're separated, you know, from things that you ought to be connected to, that's what happens. It breaks you down. You feel like you can't get it together. But the text told us that as soon as we begin to do what God tells us to do, things begin to come together again. And if you're listening to me, you need to reconnect. I want you to note that in the comment section. Note it in the comment section. I got to get back with God. I got to get back on the battlefield. I've heard the wind of the word, and I feel like finally I can catch my breath. Finally, I got the breather that I need from the wind of the word. I'm ready. I'm ready to come back. I got some bones now, but I'm ready to come back. And if that's you, note that in the comment section. Note it. You can call 301-200-1615. And we'll help you get reconnected. We'll help you gain your vitality back through the wind of God's word. Perhaps you want to be a part of this ministry. I would love to be your pastor. Honestly, I would love to be your Ezekiel. From a prophetic perspective, always reminding you that even if I don't have answers, God has the answers. And he'll give us the answers if we would just listen. Doesn't matter if God give you an answer. If you're not listening, it's not going to be impactful in your life. You see? And even when he gives you the answer, you're going to have to walk out the directions of that answer. And as soon as you do, before you get finished, things will start coming together again. Because he knows how to take you from a valley to a valley. Mentality. And so if you're listening to me and you want to be a part of this ministry and God is leading you to do that, listen to him. Listen to him. If he's telling you, be a part. I would love to be your pastor. All right? And I want to pray for you that God will give you what you need to get reconnected. You know, some of you saved and some of you love the Lord, but you've been in a prolonged valley. And that valley has gotten your attention. And you need to rededicate now. You've been talking about years and years and years. No, no, no. You got to do it now. He said, command. He told Ezekiel, now speak to the wind, speak to what you don't see. I know there's some things that you perhaps may not see, but you got to speak to it and say, it will be. Speak those things that be not as though they were. No, I'm going to rededicate today. I had no plan to do it, but I'm going to do it. I pray that everything that's been said, I pray that it has accomplished that which you have set out to accomplish for your glory. And God, I pray that every bone that's missing, every person that's missing from the body of Christ, that you will connect them, reconnect them right now. Let the reconnection process begin right now as they are doing what it is that you have told them to do. Let the reconnection process begin now. And God, we who have bones ourselves, God, help us to receive them. Help us to embrace them. Help us, God, to be relatable. Help us to be honest when it comes to the things that we struggle with as well. But God, you have still, through the midst of it all, given us all life, life that only we can find in you. So God, we receive those individuals, if they be in it, in the spirit of love and the spirit of togetherness. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. I pray that you enjoy this message on this morning from Valley to Vitality. And I want you to understand that all of us have been in a prolonged valley experience. But I want you to know that God can take you from valley to vitality. The problem is that, you know, we break down in a valley. We get shattered in a valley. We become disconnected in a valley. That's in a lot of cases, that's why people disconnect from the church. It's because of valley experiences of all sorts, you see. But there is no valley that you can be in that God can't get you out of and give you the vitality that you need in order for you to be reconnected to the body of Christ. So I say happy National Back to Church Sunday. I pray that everything that was said was rewarding. It was understood. We are an army. We are an army of God. And we are doing our best to make sure that we fight the good fight of faith. And hang in there, because at the close of the day, we want to hear our master say, well done, well done, and well done. Please keep James Drummond in prayer, Janet Codman, Cynthia Grant Vincent, Deacon Mark DeShazo, Lena Brown and family, Kim Curtis and family. Please keep those individuals in prayer. Let's pray for everybody. Let's pray for everybody. Let's pray for everybody that's going through that we may not even know about, but we're going to keep them in our prayers. Because we know that God is a prayer-answering God. All right. Rest in peace, Bishop Ellis, Justice Ginsburg, all those who have departed from this earth. Rest in peace. I was told that Mother Leek's birthday was last Sunday. I just want the Leek family to know that we're still praying for them. And we sincerely miss her. We know exactly where she is. She's resting in the arms of God. And but we absolutely, from a natural perspective, we miss her and all the loved ones that have been lost. Just know that your church family is praying for you. We're thinking about you. We love you. And we thank God that he has at least kept us together. And remember, you know, we are stronger together, and we're not going to let anything divide us, you see. And even if you know, you've been in a valley experience. God is going to give you back your vitality back. And you get that when we learn how to stick together, to remain together, because it's in togetherness, in the spirit of togetherness, we find strength. In Jesus' name. Well, may the Lord keep you, is my prayer. And remember, we are MCC strong. Why? Because we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. God bless.
Of Bishop Melvin Robinson Jr. and First Lady Cheryl Robinson, thank you for attending the Master's Child Church Cyber Sanctuary. We enjoyed worshiping with you. If this teaching has been a blessing to you, we encourage you to sow a seed with any of these giving options. Givelify, search Master's Child Church, specify your amount, and done. The Cash App, $ Master's Child. Our church website, www.masterschild.org. Or use our mailing address, P.O. Box 7810, Upper Marlboro, Maryland, 20792. And join us this week for our weekly services. 6 a.m. prayer, Monday through Friday, our conference call. Noonday prayer, on Tuesdays, via our conference call. Real Word Wednesday, 7:30 p.m., Facebook Live. Walking in Newness, radio broadcast, 10 a.m., Facebook Live. And Sunday Morning Manna, 11 a.m., Facebook Live. As a reminder, if you have any questions or need prayer during the week, please contact the church office at 301-200-1615. Thank you for joining the Master's Child Church. Love never fails.